Hello, I am Fonzawong Anslem, and today we are going to continue with our lessons on computer programming. And today we are going to take up the lesson on algorithmic structures. So, what are the objectives for this lesson? By the end of this lesson, we expect that you should be able to list the three control structures that exist, and you should also be able to draw diagrams representing each of the structures concerned, and also you should be able to identify control structures found in problems. Yes, and finally, we are going to look at the characteristics of a good algorithm. So without wasting any time, we are going to move to the control structures. So we are going to begin with the sequence, and the sequence is a control structure that follows statements written in a specific order. As you see, we have statement one. After doing statement one, we go to statement two, followed by statement three, and so on. So the instructions or the inputs are executed exactly in the order in which they appear. So that is the sequence. A simple algorithm that will imply the use of sequence is like the wake-up algorithm. You see that when we wake up from bed, what do we do first? Maybe you brush your teeth. That's the first statement. You could enter the first statement. The second thing we do could be we take our breakfast. For example, you take the breakfast. It is a second statement. And then the sequence continues with the third thing you do. The third thing you do could be maybe you take a bath to prepare for school. You see that the statements follow each other. So that makes the control structure sequence. So the second algorithmic structure we are going to look at is the selection. The selection, as the name implies, is a control structure that involves choosing one path to the other when a condition is met or failed. For example, here you can see there is a condition here. When the condition is verified or true, we follow this path and we execute statement two. Everything that is found on this branch is executed. But if the condition is false, we follow rather this branch and we execute the statements that are found on this branch. So a common example of an algorithm that will involve a selection will be maybe an algorithm to determine whether someone has passed a test or not, depending on the mark. You see, for example, if the mark, so the condition will be on the mark. If the mark is greater than 50, for example, if it is true, it means that the person has passed. So all the instructions referring to those who have passed will be placed here. And if the mark is less than 50, this section, the statements here will be, on this section will be executed. So all the statements that are executed when the mark is less than 50 will be placed here. That is the selection control structure. So now we are going to look at the last control structure, which is the repetition or the loop. So as the diagram shows, we have a condition, and when the condition is verified, we have some statements that are executed. It could be one statement or a block of statements. And so when the statements are executed, the program goes back and verifies the condition. So you see that the program will continue to execute this statement so long as the condition is true. But once this condition becomes false, the program goes out and continues with other statements that may be here. So the essence here is to show the fact that there is repetition when so long as the condition is verified here. And that is what we call the repetition or the loop. So to end this, our series on the flowchart, it is a good thing that we look at the characteristics of a good algorithm. So the first characteristic and the most important to me is a good algorithm should have well-defined inputs and outputs. What do we mean here? When we are writing an algorithm will always require some inputs, some preconditions, things that must be available for it to run. And at the end of every algorithm, we said the algorithm was to solve a problem or to achieve a particular goal. The goal must be achieved. So the input must correspond exactly to the output. So we should have a guarantee that when our inputs are well specified, we are going to have correct outputs in the end. That is the first characteristic of a good algorithm. The second characteristic of a good algorithm is what we call finiteness. Okay, as you rightly guess, it means a good algorithm should have an end. After a sequence or a certain number of steps, the algorithm should end, and it should end while giving us correct outputs for correct inputs. Okay, so when the inputs and the outputs are well defined, the algorithm should end with well defined outputs, which are, of course, correct outputs. So the third characteristic of a good algorithm is feasibility. So a good algorithm should be feasible. Good. Feasible or doable. What do we mean here? We should not write algorithms that cannot be achieved. When we talk about feasibility here, we are talking about the resources that the algorithm uses. So we should write algorithm that use available resources. So the algorithm should be achievable. That is what we mean by feasibility, or writing an algorithm which is doable. And now, of course, the fourth characteristic of a good algorithm is unambiguity. So a good algorithm should be unambiguous. Voilà. What do we mean here? A good algorithm should have well-defined steps. The steps should be clear. It means that when I am executing the algorithm, for each step, I should know exactly what the writer intended. So the algorithm should not have statements which will create some confusion. That is what we mean by unambiguity. So a good algorithm should have clear steps which are well-defined. And last of all, we are going to look at the last characteristic of an algorithm, which is independence. So a good algorithm should be independent. So, independent, not. So a good algorithm should be independent. Okay, at times it is difficult to write this. Okay, so a good algorithm should be independent. Independent of what? So here we are talking about independence of a programming language. So so that was it for our lesson of today, in which we were looking at the algorithmic structures. We saw the sequence, the selection, and the repetition or the loop. And also we looked at the characteristics of a good algorithm, which include well-defined inputs and outputs, finiteness, feasibility, and unambiguity and independence of a particular programming language. Thank you all for watching, and see you in our next series.
Sonny man, the other Sonny man, you understand? The one where money no day, he come light.